All right, everybody, welcome back to the laboratory. Dr. Cranky in the house. Just a few things. I wanted to do a new sequence of little videos that basically are little things that I remember or that I dig up or that I find or that I do, just to show you guys some of the things that you might have laying around in your workshop already, and you know, they'll come in useful, or stuff that you find at the store. So let me begin with the simplest thing first. This is from the craft store. I picked it up just a few days ago. It's called Color Mesh Origami. And all it is just different colored mesh screen type things. Perfect scale for 1/24. But also for airbrushing. You could airbrush through this and simple texture. And a little packet like this comes with about 20 sheets. So you could do all kinds of neat stuff with it, I guess. Airbrushing and also with screen mesh for all sorts of things. It'll be up to your imagination. The other thing are these alligator clips. I found them today laying around. And I had four, and then some chopsticks, and so I crazy glue them on here, and I could use them now for holding parts. Now, you have to be careful with these, because the teeth are pretty strong, the grip is pretty strong, and the teeth are going to leave mark on your parts, so you have to be careful where you put these. That's why I use my simple chopstick with double-sided, you know, tape for parts that you want to be careful with. So just stuff laying around. The other thing is, for those of you who want to sand your tires, this was an old trick that somebody must have invented a long time ago, and I just the other day somebody mentioned, I think it was Fast Jimmy 71, talking about sanding tires, and I remember, oh wait a minute, I remember I had one of these little contraptions. So you go to the hardware store, you pick up two washers. They have different size washers depending on the size of the tire. Okay, one nut here, or one bolt, whatever you call it, and two lug nuts. All right, and what you do is I got a long thing here it's gonna, you know, require a little bit of turning, but it's matters of seconds here. So you put one in. Then you put a washer in, all right? Then you put your tire in, okay? Then you put your other washer in. Make sure that the tire is centered so that it's not going to go through, all right? Then you put your other nut on here, all right? Make sure that everything is centered, all right? Holding the tire really, really tight. There we go. But not so tight that the washers will go through the tire. All right, just so that it's firm. There you go. You have the contraption right there. Okay, then you take your power drill. You chuck it on there. Okay, you take your sanding stick. This is probably mostly out of battery. I haven't used this in a while. So you just go, you know, in a matter of seconds, you can remove the entire thread if you want it, and but if you just want to sand it and age your tires a little bit to remove that factory sheen and gloss, that's it. So it's as easy as keeping your eyes open and looking out for stuff that are going to be useful and are going to cut down on your time doing tedious things. I like doing tedious things because I'm OCD. So, and repetitive action really soothes my nerves in the laboratory. But keep your eyes open, and if you don't, I'll have them open for you, and I'll keep an eye out for stuff. So stay tuned in for these kinds of videos, and I'll do a few more. All right, stay tuned in. Thank you.